Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. I want to begin by thanking Mr. Miller, the Inspector General at GSA, for bringing to light this gross abuse of taxpayer funds and for his work over the past year investigating the conference in 2010. 2 weeks ago, I, along with the rest of the nation, was appalled to learn the results of this investigation, that GSA employees betrayed the trust we placed in them. For example, the Inspector General's report described the actions of Jeff Neely, a career GSA employee for many years and a senior-level executive in the Pacific Rim region based in San Francisco. He is certainly not the only official implicated in this investigation, and several others appear to have maximized their own benefit in an environment in which they knew they could get away with it. Nevertheless, Mr. Neely's role as the host of the 2010 conference has raised significant questions. According to the report, Mr. Neely engaged in an indefensible and intolerable pattern of misconduct, including repeatedly violating federal travel and procurement rules, holding lavish parties in luxury suites, and allowing his wife and other non-government officials to participate in some of these events at taxpayers' expense. In addition, documents obtained by the Inspector General indicate that Mr. Neely was aware that his actions were inappropriate. In one email, Mr. Neely invited personal friends to the conference, writing, and I quote, and this is simply incredible, quote, "We'll get you guys a room near us, and we'll pick up the room tab. Could be a blast," end of quote. He then went on and wrote this, "I know I'm bad, but as Deb and I often say, why not enjoy it while we have it and while we can? Ain't going to last forever," end of quote. Well, Mr. Neely, it stops now. The record indicates that Mr. Neely's wife personally handled party arrangements, directed the actions of federal employees, and ordered thousands of dollars in food at not their expense, but the expense of taxpayers. In one case, Mr. Neely's wife reportedly impersonated a federal employee so she could join him at a private sector conference. The impression that conveyed by these documents is that Mr. Neely and his wife believe they were some sort of agency royalty who used taxpayer funds to bankroll their lavish lifestyle. They disregarded one of the most basic tenets of government service. It's not your money. It's the taxpayers' money. Some of my questions today will be about the Inspector General's recommendation to get some of that money back. I want to know how we can recoup these funds, including from Mr. Neely and other GSA employees personally. I understand the Justice Department may be examining Mr. Neely's actions and that he intends to invoke the Fifth Amendment today. That is his right under the Constitution, and the committee should act responsibly in respecting his decision. However, I do not support granting Mr. Neely immunity at this time, Mr. Chairman. On Thursday, the Chairman sent a letter to Mr. Neely's attorney suggesting that the Chairman was considering immunizing him. On Friday, Mr. Neely's attorney responded positively, writing that Mr. Neely, quote, "will abide by the appropriate court order and the procedure set forth under the immunity statute," end of quote. Granting immunity is a serious action that should not be entered into lightly, since it could negatively impact the future criminal prosecution or prosecutions. Such a decision requires thoughtful considerations and consultation with the Justice Department. Our committee has had no consultations about this, and I see no reason to immunize Mr. Neely if he has taken the actions of which he stands accused. In addition to addressing the actions of specific individuals, we need to understand how GSA's system allowed this pattern in this case, the extent to which it happened in previous cases, and the reforms necessary to prevent it from ever happening again. According to interviews by the Inspector General's office, these activities were going on for years. When discussing the 2010 conference, one witness stated, the planning of it was similar to what happened in previous WRCs, we just kind of proceeded based on that. When investigators asked another witness whether the 2010 conference was an outlier, he said it was pretty consistent with previous conferences and that although Mr. Neely wanted to do better than they did in New Orleans in 2008, there was not much difference. Let me close by noting that one of the most damaging aspects of this incident is that it tarnishes the reputation of hardworking government workers who dedicate their lives to public service. It gives them a bad name, and it is completely unfair. There are scrupulous employees across this government who follow the rules every single day. They pull their money out of their own pockets just to pay for coffee at their offices. They are honest and hardworking, and they should not be painted with the same brush. Mr. Chairman, I thank you for calling this hearing, and with that, I yield back.